This is the entrance hall. Too much noise. We're still missing a vital piece of the puzzle.
you doing here? So it was you. Much more astonishing than I imagined. I'm impressed.
No! Don't! I'm not into this stuff!
Ah! Yeah.
Thank you. Yes.
You? What are you doing here?
So it was you. Much more astonishing than I imagined. I'm impressed.
No! Don't! I'm not into this stuff!
Amazing. Shot. Bullseye. Yes, they shot.
You? What are you doing here?
So it was you. Much more astonishing than I imagined. I'm impressed.
No! Don't! I'm not into this stuff! Ah!
Yeah.
Thank you. Nick.
Agent Morgan, where are you? Answer me! Come on, open up!
Call for assistance with the body.
Wait! She's still alive.
Diane, don't move. Don't move her hands and stay still.
George, it's no good. It won't budge.
Emily, stand back.
Thomas, call an ambulance.
What? A what?
Agent York, George, are you okay?
Yes, I'm okay. I think I'm too old to be an acrobat, though.
Diane looks okay, too. She should be able to tell us who did this to her.
God, I hope so. But you, George. Quite a catch. I'm impressed.
Hmm?
George? Diane.
Oh, yeah. What a beautiful beach. The reaching ground who feel off in many directions. Combination of soft voices, night away, interruptiveness, inspiring a truly deep eroticism in all who clear. Every woman will find her pride about being penetrated by your soft voice. This piece is most unimaginable to God. And yet, this is far more than a water piece of art. It is a piece of masterpiece. My elephant kind of
goes and
flowers. Tom Croker, begging things.
Diane!
Stop right there, Nick. You're under arrest for the attempted murder of Diane Ames.
Huh. Back off! Don't touch me!
Emily, hurry!
I requested... And...
Thomas will need a body bag, too. Nick, quiet.
Can you hear that?
Hmm?
I think he wants us to follow him. Shall we follow, Zach?
Willie, are you out there?
Kaysen, what are you doing in there?
York, is that you? Thank God, I can't get this door open. Can you unlock it from your side?
Kaysen, stand away from the door.
Where's Diane? And what are you doing here?
I was going to ask you the same thing.
Well, let's just say I have my reasons, you know, private reasons. I don't really have to tell you, do I?
Actually, you do. Diane just died a moment ago.
What?
You're not just a key witness now. You're now a suspect. And you need to tell me exactly what you were doing here.
Well, I just came here to talk with Diane. To have a conversation.
And I suppose that kiss mark on your cheek is from your conversation.
This was just a spur-of-the-moment thing.
Which is exactly what killed Diane.
Okay, okay. I came here to be with Diane. You happy now? We've been together before, a couple times. It's one of the reasons why I like coming to this town, see? This time is no different. I bumped into her in a bar in Seattle. I had some holiday coming up. Well, so I just took it and I drove her back here. I have a wife, you know, but we've been separated for a while. We're going through a divorce right now, and I don't want her lawyer finding out. Anyway, how could I kill Diane if I was in a room locked from the outside? 2 hours ago, me and Diane, we were taking it easy, drinking upstairs. We were, you know, enjoying ourselves. Then Nick had to show up. Well, then Diane had a sudden change of heart. She locked me up in here. I've just been here, waiting for her to come back, of course, but she didn't. I heard footsteps a couple of times, but they just passed by. Well, then I couldn't wait anymore, so I let Willie here out through the window. Then you showed up instead of Diane.
Zach, Diane has become the third victim of our killer. And nada from questioning Nick. Nothing. Got no new leads from questioning Nick. He's taken the death of Diane really badly. In shock, the works. He claims to have liked talking with her about art. But he also had a problem with her views about men. He says that they argued, but not at a level that would lead to a murder. They were about to head out to the bar again together. But while he was waiting for Diane, someone knocked him out cold. He has no idea who it was, either. Of course, Kaysen looks like a prime suspect. But that door was locked from the outside. There was no other way in or out of that room. Which means there is no evidence of his involvement at this time. He did say something else. The footsteps he heard outside the room were not heels, but a man's boots. And Nick was wearing boots. But now that Diane's dead, no one can back up Nick's statement. Which is why we have Nick in custody and have to let Kaysen go free. That seemed like the only option, at least for now.
One more thing, Zach. George looked terribly depressed. I guess this case is really getting to him.
He's feeling responsible for the deaths of Becky and Diane. Take his rules and confidence away from him? I wonder what's left. Well, of course, he'd still have muscle.